None of the producers have any financial interest in the products or procedures shown.
Single pass 4-throw pupilloplasty is a new technique for performing pupilloplasty. First of all, catch the iris with a forceps, pass a straight needle 10-0 or 9-0 proline. From the other end, pass a 26 gauge needle through a clear corneal incision into the iris, do a railroad technique, pass the suture out and create a loop. Once this loop is made, now pass 4 throws. Remember, 4 throws. Once you have 4 throws, you have one thread on one end here and the other is the one which is on the side of the clear corneal incision where you have made. Now pull both together and once you have done that, you can now cut that with a micro scissor. Now you can do the same on the other side and lo and behold, you have a small pupil. Now let's take a traumatic subluxated cataract which has a traumatic mydriasis. In this case, we did a glued IOL. We had two scleral flaps and once the glued IOL was done, we started working on the single pass 4-throw pupilloplasty. And you can see the proline needle passing through the cornea and from the other end the 26 gauge needle going through the entry wound in the AC. The loop has been made, the throws put 4 throws and the two ends pulled to get the pupilloplasty done. The micro scissor subsequently cuts the suture. Same thing is going to be done on the other end and you will notice we are using an endoluminator all the time for visualization. Here you can see from the other end also a loop created. Now 4 throws made and the two ends of the suture pulled. Once you have got the pupilloplasty done, you can make the pupil more round by just tugging on the iris to see how round the pupil is. Air is put and you can see pre and post-op. Let's look at another case which had an optic capture because it was a large white-to-white eye and we did a glued IOL. Now once again you can see the single pass 4-throw pupilloplasty being done. The proline suture has been passed, the 26 gauge needle has been passed and through a railroad technique the suture comes out. In all such cases, always have fluid in the eye rather than viscoelastic. Here you can see we are using a trocar AC maintainer, but you can alternatively use an AC maintainer. If the eye is aphakic, you can also use a pars plana cannula. Once again, 4 throws are done, the two ends of the suture pulled and you have your pupilloplasty done. Look at the advantage of the endoluminator because it gives great visualization. Both ends are done and you can see the optic capture has been solved. Single pass 4-throw pupilloplasty we just started for closed angle glaucoma. Now you see in this case there is an IOL there, circumcornal in the eye, we fixed infusion cannula. But if you notice carefully, the iris is stuck to the cornea there. There is a total closed angle glaucoma. We're making a small incision in the clear corneal incision and removing the silicone oil. The fluid is continuously going through the infusion cannula. Most of the oil has come out. If there is need, we can also go through the pars plana to remove the remaining silicone oil. Here you can see we are just using the pars plana trocars and sucking out the silicone oil and you can see the silicone oil removed completely. Now once you have done that, we want to solve the problem of the closed angle glaucoma. We are using the glued IOL forceps to pull the iris together. Once the anterior synechia are broken, now the next step is to do the single pass 4-throw pupilloplasty. So you can see we are taking the proline suture, passing it from one end, from the other end we pass the 26 gauge needle and using the single pass technique, 4 throws are being passed and we are tightening the suture. So the basic principle of the single pass 4-throw pupilloplasty for closed angle glaucomas is, once you have broken the peripheral anterior sinecae, sutured the iris together, the whole pupil is made narrower. Once it is made narrower and you can do as many sutures as you feel necessary, the angles have become open, and this will automatically solve the problem of glaucoma. They don't need any trabeculectomy picture, and the same intraocular pressure 32 has become 11. Look at the anterior segment OCT pre-op closed and the post-op open, again pre and post.